Welcome back to New Day Cleveland. Gonna love the sound of this one. How about never dieting again? It is music to the ears, right? Well, here with the foods that will help you lose weight and stay slim without dieting is Laura Jeffers, registered dietitian from the Cleveland Clinic. She's always so good about bringing in some really unique ideas for us to try and live a healthier lifestyle. And I love the sound of not having to diet, because I hate that word.
Right.
I hate that word.
Me too. So I definitely think that we can do some of these things.
Okay, so but these seem like pretty simple items. I'll have you start with on the end there with the garlic.
Yeah, so garlic. Really, research shows that there is a component in garlic called allicin, and it actually helps to break down harmful bacteria in your gut, which means if the gut is healthy, you're gonna have less belly bloat. So you'll feel, you know, and look slimmer.
Very interesting.
All it is cooking with it or putting it in your food.
And then you just make sure you brush your teeth afterwards.
Right.
Do they suggest a certain amount a day and something like that?
Not necessarily. Okay. I mean, I wouldn't overdo it, especially if you're not used to eating it.
Because it will start seeping through your pores then, right?
And you'll offend everyone around you.
Exactly. But that's really interesting to know about that.
Yeah, for sure. So black beans, or beans in general, are they're known for being full of fiber and protein, which is really helpful for satiety, makes you feel full. And so to stave off cravings, that helps you. So you're not craving like carbohydrates and things like that. So that's beneficial.
So it fills you up. I love this, because there's things about these foods I feel like that I know they're good for me, but I don't really understand why.
Yeah.
So
for
that's
sure.
more of a filling mechanism to kind of help you.
Correct. And
not
research shows
so
that you won't go later, you know, maybe craving something. So, or at least be able to say no to it.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so seaweed.
Seaweed
actually has a compound in it that actually burns fat. So it's kind of like the fat burner. I was also reading that there's research now looking at a compound in there that would turn into a gel in the stomach, make you feel full. I don't know, it's still being researched, but that could be something down the pike that could also help you. But this is really good too. It has nutrients, you know, good source of protein, so.
Do I need to eat it? I love it obviously with sushi, but do I need to eat it by itself maybe instead of?
No, I think
just getting my
getting it. No, eating it with sushi. I don't know. They do have like those seaweed salads. Have you tried that?
They are very good. They
are good. Mm-hmm. So that would be another way to get it.
Okay.
In.
But, all right. Mm-hmm.
So the jalapenos.
Jalapenos.
Yep.
I would think that just goes right through you. So that's how it helps you.
Yeah. No. So actually, the jalapeno that has an anti-inflammatory. Compound that really helps fat burning. So it speeds up your metabolism. It's gonna calorie burner. So that is really gonna be helpful. And it helps you burn it longer. So, you know, that it kind of sticks with. So that's really good. And that's easy to put in your food. And two, it's kind of takes away that taste, you know, when you just want to eat more, when you've got that hot in your mouth, you know, you're kind of
done.
Satisfied.
Exactly.
Yeah, you know.
It definitely helps.
Definitely.
Because, your mouth's tingling a little bit. You're like, okay, I'm good. I agree with you on that one. Okay,
so
potatoes, I'm really excited about
I know.
This.
I'm dying to talk about this.
I'm really excited
because
about
I feel like people watching are going to be like, what?
Exactly.
I'm going to get phone calls later. I know, from my colleagues.
So how is that good for you then?
So the white potato actually has there's a fatty acid that forms and it ferments in your gut, and that actually helps burn fat. So research does show, and in mice, I guess, they found that it also helps with energy expenditure, meaning like it helps to burn calories, maybe, you know, looking at metabolism. But again, you know, this is the other thing. People think, oh my gosh, I can't have potatoes. You can have it. It's just the amounts.
And what you put on it, probably, too,
yes,
right?
That is true.
Because I probably wouldn't eat it plain. I would add sour cream. I would add salsa. I would add butter.
And I would recommend salsa.
Okay, like, yeah, salsa
would
be bad,
good.
Right?
Did you say hot sauce? I think that
sauce
would be great. And maybe had some jalapeno on there, right?
There you go.
So
we just created a lunch for you right there.
But maybe eat half of that.
Okay. That's where I struggle,
and then half
too.
Later.
Portion control is my biggest obstacle.
Yeah.
Okay, last but not least.
Okay, so this is mango. These are dried, and so you want to watch with the portioning with that. But just to give an example, mangoes have been shown to help lower blood sugar. And so eating those, they also have fiber in them, you know, whereas a lot of foods do. But again, that's just another healthy aspect. So, you know, getting mango in as part of your fruit intake would be helpful.
I love this. You got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different things that you can now put into your diet that you know is actually helping you, as long as you are using portion control when it comes to it, right?
Yep.
Thanks,
Laura.
Right.
Thanks
so
a lot.
Good to have you here as usual.